There was a terrible crash of thunder. Ben rubbed the locket between his fingers, then turned a few pages ahead. These early collections, centuries ago, were stored in pieces of furniture called cabinets of wonders. The cabinets were ornately carved, with dozens of tiny doors and drawers and hidden spaces filled with a nearly infinite variety of amazing items. Here, one could find everything from precious gems to unicorn horns, intricately carved ivory, and magical cups that could cure all poisons. Great and glorious works of art resided in these collections, side by side with the wonders of nature. Some collections grew beyond the confines of a single cabinet and took over entire rooms. The viewer was able to walk into one of these rooms and, as if reading a book, understand the wonder of the world just from the stories told by the collected objects and how they were displayed. See Figure 26. Figure 26 showed an old drawing of the room described above. Almost the entire room was covered in shelves, like his mom's library, except the shelves were much fancier, and it was filled with the strangest objects, some of which hung from the ceiling above. There were ornate glass jars, drawers of shells and bones, rows of birds, mysterious sea creatures, human heads and alligators, strangely shaped sculptures, and many things Ben couldn't identify at all. In the center of the room was an intricately carved cabinet with a crown of seashells and coral on top. Ben studied it in amazement. The viewer was indeed supposed to feel a kind of wonder and awe while looking at everything laid out before him. If you've ever stood beneath the skeleton of a dinosaur, or gazed at a giant diamond, or come upon something beautiful in nature, a glowing red flower, perhaps, growing alone from a cracked sidewalk, you know this feeling of wonder. A brilliant bolt of lightning, white hot and electric, came hurtling out of the sky, accompanied by another huge crash of thunder. The lights went out. Ben wanted to go back to his cousin's house now. He tucked the book into the back of his pants, pulled out his flashlight, and made his way to the kitchen. He couldn't find any umbrellas, so he took one of his mom's winter coats from the hall closet and held it over his head for protection against the rain. Lightning kept flashing, momentarily illuminating the room like flash bulbs on a camera. Another crack of thunder shook the house, and Ben realized he had better wait out the storm here. 83 steps could be very far in weather like this. He put away his mom's coat and returned to her room. He crawled into the indentation in her bed and lay on his back. He propped the flashlight against his shoulder so it pointed upward, and he held the book directly over him. Just as he was about to start reading again, something fluttered out of the book and landed on his chest. It was an old bookmark. Ben sat up and inspected it. The bookmark was frayed at the edges, and on it was a black and white drawing of a storefront with books piled up in the window and spilling out of boxes and shelves on the sidewalk. A black cat sat listlessly near the door. The awning above the windows read Kincaid Books. At the bottom were the store's address and phone number. Ben turned the bookmark over. In black ink, someone had written, February 1965, Elaine, this piece of me is for you. Please write or call. I'll be waiting. Love, Danny. Beneath that were a phone number and an address in New York City.